In this video, I'm going to be talking about Revit stairs, and we're going to be exploring how we can actually use a stringer, not just for the structural part of the stair, but as railing as well. Once you extend the stringer far enough, it acts in as railing, but also it opens up the opportunity to add railing on top of that stringer to use it as both a handrail on top or a handrail on the side. So we're going to be exploring how we can set all of this up. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. And now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and let's place first our stair. This will be a spiral stair, so let's go to circulation, click on the stair tool, and then I'm going to set the type and family at the assembled stair, 190 millimeter riser, and then 150 going. For the type of stair or the placement, I'm going to use the center and spiral. Then I'm just going to click here in the center, zoom in a little bit. You want to extend it so it's like this, like open. And then let's just extend it like that. You want to go full circle so we have zero remaining risers. Click to place, and that's what we have. Now I'm just going to also go here to railing and then just set the default railing to none and then click OK. Finally, we can go to the 3D view, see what we have, hit finish. And there we go, we have our stair. The next step is going to be to start adjusting it. So I'm just going to place it like this. We can even turn on some shadows, nice. And then let's go and select the stair, go here into edit type, and let's start changing it. So the first thing that I'm going to change is going to be the run type. So let's go here to the run type, and then I'm just going to hit here edit. I'm going to duplicate this run type, and this will be just a tread without a riser. So just like this, click OK. And then I'm just going to come to riser, uncheck, and then hit apply. OK, so hit apply again, and it's going to remove all of the risers, making this kind of a more open stair. Then we want to get rid of the support on the inner side. So that's going to be the right support. So let's go here, or sorry, that's going to be the left support. So yeah, let's go to the left support, stringer closed, and just change it to none, hit apply. And now that's going to be opened up like this. Finally, for the right support, we want to extend that. So that's going to be basically acting in as part of the railing, and it's going to be holding everything in place. So it does have to be a bit larger. So let's then go to the right support, and then below that we have the right support type. Click on that, click edit. Let's duplicate this type. This will be stringer 100 millimeter width. Get rid of this, click OK. And then for the width, set that to 100 millimeters. Then for the total depth, we want to set that to 1000 millimeters. And then finally, for the structural depth on the run, let's just reduce that to 50 millimeters. So just by deleting this. Okay, so then we can hit apply. Okay, apply, and it's going to look like this. So we have our stair. So I'm just going to click OK, just to OK out of that, and then this is the end result. Now the next step that I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy this stair. So let's go back into level one, go to copy, and then let's copy it just like this, because I want to show you a couple of options in terms of the handrails which we're going to be placing. So let's get started. I'm going to go here to railing, expand the drop menu, and here we have the place on a stair ramp option. I'm just going to click on that, and then let's set this to stringer, and we can now select this stair. So it's just going to place that. You can see this is the type which is placed, the railing 1100 millimeters. That's perfectly fine. And then let's click here out of that. So this looks fairly good. So right now I just want to get rid of this inner side just because we don't need it. And then let's now modify this railing here. So I'm just going to hit edit and then I'm going to duplicate this type. So this will be, let's call it our new railing. Click OK. And then let's start making some modifications. So first for the baluster placement, you want to go here into edit. Then you want to find your main pattern and you want to get rid of it. So you can just click here and then you can set this to none. Now for the posts, for the corner post, we want to get rid of that as well. So set it to none. And then for the start and end posts, I just want to change that from a square to a round 25 millimeter post. So let's just go like that. Okay, so once we have made these changes, let's hit apply and okay and apply and okay. And finally, it's really important to uncheck the use balusters per thread on stairs. Then you want to hit apply, okay, apply. And now as you can see, we just have that clean railing or top rail, which is attached at the bottom and at the top. Now let's select it again. And I just want to switch it from this rectangular rail or top rail. And let's go here to top rail and just switch it to something like this. Elliptical 40 by 30 millimeter, click OK, apply, looks much nicer. And then let's drop the height down to 900 millimeters, hit apply, OK, and then this is what that looks like. I really like it. Actually, I want to bring it up just a little bit, so let's try 950. Yeah, I think this is the proper height. And there we go. So this is if you want to have this top rail. Now you can also use a regular handrail. So for this stair, let's try that. So I'm just going to go here to railing. Oops, not that. A place on stair. Then I want to switch to my new railing and then let's place it on stringers as well, just like this. Go back to modify, delete this one here. Then select this new rail. Let's hit edit type. And then let's duplicate this one to handrail. Okay, so once we have named it, we can go down and then here I don't want to use the top rail. So let's perhaps move it like this so we can see the railing itself. So I no longer want to use the top rail, just like that. And I don't even want to have these, I don't even want to have these balusters here. So let's set those to none, just like that, hit apply, okay. So now let's go to handrail one, go to type, and then here I'm just going to pick out this wall mount handrail. You can play around with the materials and so on. I'm just going to leave it like this, and I'm just going to drop the height down to 800 millimeters, hit apply, okay. And then for the position, we want the position set to be on the left. Okay, hit apply, okay. And this is what that looks like. Now this handrail seems to be a little bit too much close to the stringer. So we can just select it and change the offset from path to zero, just like that. And there we go. So now we have this really nice handrail on the inside here. And here we have that top rail for the railing when we have that stringer. Now, if you would like to get access to these Revit project files or any of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.